Bom dia everyone! Today we're going to talk about flashing Bluejay on the Mobula7 1S and the issues that you might face after flashing Bluejay. Alright, so this is actually from Chop, who requested to make a Bluejay video for the Mobula7. So I've got this Mobula7 1S and this is with the X12 flight controller V2.0. It works well with this 1002 motors, but I've brought down the PIDs for this one. Just because the motors are a little overpowered, but it will work the same with the 0802 motors. So what you want to do is go to ESC-configurator.com and this will allow you to open up the firmware to flash Bluejay. Just make sure that Betaflight is not open, so if you're locked into Betaflight, it will not open the Bluejay configurator. Alright, so once that is done, click connect and then plug in your LiPo and click read setup. So here we're going to come over into this screen and this is where you're going to click flash all ESCs. As you can see, I've already had Bluejay in this particular whoop, so I'm just going to redo this again just for the video. And then we're going to select Bluejay and the ESCs will be auto selected, but just make sure that it is the same and choose your version as the latest. And we're going to choose 48 kHz for this one on the Mobula7. And then we're going to click flash all ESCs. So once all the ESCs are flashed, you want to just take note of the minimum startup power, the boost. This is set to 1050 with the maximum startup power at 1124. So just in case your motor stutters, you might want to bump up that figure into 1100 and maybe 1150. With the maximum. This one's got a 1002 motor, so I've had my RPM power protection set at 5 times. It is usually set to 9 times. Another thing that you should note about flashing Bluejay on the Mobula7 is that on the ESC configurator itself, you have to set all the motor directions to reverse. You can always change the directions on Betaflight, but on the ESC configurator itself, it has to be set to reverse. Okay, so for the PID tuning of the Mobula7, you could just fly it stock on the 0802s, but if you find that it's a little too twitchy or a little too rough, you could actually bring down the master multiplier to set your PIDs to make sure that they're flying nicely, or you could just copy my Mobula7 PIDs for the 1002 motors.
Telemetry recovered.
Ow! And that's why you should not have props on when you're doing bench testing. That was a clear example. Just saying. Okay, so I hope that helped you out a little with the Bluejay for the Mobula7, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the video.
Thank you.
So that's it for today's video. If you find that this video is useful and helpful, please do like and subscribe. And thank you all for watching, and see you guys again soon. Ciao.